First up, let's create a text entry. The text entries are primarily just for navigation purposes or for labeling things. So I'll choose File New. Now, I could actually create a text entry right now. I don't need to create a containing process book. What you'll end up, though, is with a process book that's been automatically named for you. As you can see, the name is going to be called Book 3. So that's actually possible. See, it's creating both the process book and the entry at the same time. I could choose text, and I can say, OK, this is my page 1, something like that. Now, since it is the very first element, we have no choice but to give this a level 1. So what I've done there is essentially the same thing as doing this. I could have done this in two steps, done File New, and then done a process book first. I'll call this one Book 4. And then after doing that, do File New, and then an entry called Page 1. Now, what is a text entry good for? As you can see, it doesn't actually do anything. If I go into Run Mode, it doesn't actually do anything. Let me close one of these. I don't need both of them. It doesn't actually do anything. If I double-click, nothing happens. You'll notice from our demo that we have these things primarily as just kind of labels. So refinery is a simple label. That is a text entry. If we go into build mode, you can see that's what this is. Now, you don't have to have these. You could easily make the first items on each of these pages. They could easily be a display. But as I said, in our site, we decided to adopt this convention where in book view, the very first entry ends up being a text entry, just as to serve as a type of label. Now, one last thing. If you're going to be adding a second page to this, and it's also going to be at a level 1, okay, always make sure you deselect what you're currently looking at. You can do that by just clicking over here on some blank space. If I were to select this, you know, the Windows convention is when you add new things, it pushes whatever you're currently on down. So what you'll end up with is if I were to insert something right now by doing File New and then add a page 2, for example, while that's selected, it's going to end up my page 2 is going to be before my page 1. Just the kind of an artifact of the design of Windows. If something's selected, it's going to be pushing anything else that you create down. Yeah, so that we end up with something like this. So just make sure you deselect before you do that, and that won't be an annoyance. It's a fairly minor issue. Of course, the easiest way to fix this is to go into Outline View and just grab these and move this down, or just arrange these by hand. There we go. Now back in Book View, we have page 1 and page 2 where they should be.